Even now, says the Lord, return to me with your whole heart, with fasting and weeping and mourning. Rend your hearts, not your garments, and return to the Lord your God. Be gracious and merciful, is he, slow in anger, rich in kindness, and relenting in punishment. Perhaps he will again relent and leave behind him a blessing, offerings and libations for the Lord your God.
The response is, be merciful, O Lord, for we have sinned.
Be merciful, O Lord, for we have sinned.
Have mercy on me, O God, in your goodness, in the greatness of your compassion. Wipe out my offense. Thoroughly wash me from my guilt, and of my sin cleanse me.
Be merciful, O Lord, for we have
sinned. For I acknowledge my offense, and my sin is before me always. Against you only have I sinned and done what is evil in your sight.
Be merciful, O Lord, for we have sinned.
A clean heart create for me, O God, and a steadfast spirit renew within me. Cast me not out from your presence, and your Holy Spirit take not from me. Give me back the joy of your salvation, and a willing spirit sustain in me. O Lord, open my lips, and my mouth shall proclaim your praise. Brothers and sisters, we are ambassadors for Christ, as if God were appealing through us. We implore you on behalf of Christ, be reconciled to God. For our sake, he made him to be sin, who did not know sin, so that we might become the righteousness of God in him. Working together, then, we appeal to you not to receive the grace of God in man, for he says, in an exceptional time, I heard you, and on the day of salvation, I helped you. Behold, now is a very exceptional time. Behold, now is the day of salvation. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you. Reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to his disciples, take care not to perform righteous deeds in order that people may see them. Otherwise, you will receive no recompense from your heavenly Father. When you give alms, do not blow the trumpet before you, as the hypocrites do in the synagogues and in the streets, to win the praise of others. Amen, I say to you, they have received their reward. But when you give alms, do not let your left hand know what your right hand is doing, so that your alms may be secret, and your Father, who sees in secret, will repay you. When you pray, do not be like the hypocrites, who love to stand and pray in the synagogues and on the street corners, so that others may see them. Amen, I say to you, they will receive their reward.
Good morning, brothers and sisters. You know, it is always a joy for a priest when he is celebrating Mass, and he sees many people filling many pews. And then when we look at the empty pews, there's a cause for sadness. And I just want to say at the outset, you know, as Catholics, sometimes we reserve the practice of our faith for Easter Sunday, or Christmas morning, or Ash Wednesday. And we have this kind of sporadic approach to the Lord, where on these key days, we would be willing to church. And if you are one of those people, I would encourage you to come to Mass every Sunday at least. and have a great regard for the great gift of your own soul, and great regard for the truth that you really do need Jesus Christ active and working in your life. The sin of pride of life and all of the sins that come under the umbrella of pride of life, I mean, there are many. But prayer counteracts that. It mortifies that, because prayer, sincere prayer, real prayer, will always help us grow in humility. And a humble soul will not be prone or given over to the sins of pride. Humility is one of the great safeguards of the soul. It is one of the great gifts. And you know, sometimes we desire so many gifts from the Lord, but sometimes we don't desire the greater gifts. And one of the greatest gifts that the Lord can give us is one of the least desired. It is humility. And without humility, nothing. There is no virtue when humility is absent. It's like trying to plant a garden in a place that has no soil. Jesus bought us at a very dear price, at the cost of his own life on the cross. And look at this cross when you go home, when you see it in prayer, when you see it in others, and realize that we all are destined for something wonderful. O God, we are moved by acts of humility and respond with forgiveness to works of penance. Let your merciful ear for our prayers, and in your kindness pour out the grace of your blessing on your servants who are marked with these ashes, that as they follow the Lenten observances, they may be worthy to come with mine to be here to celebrate the Paschal mystery of your Son, through Christ our Lord. I invite you to come up as you would for Holy Communion, for the distribution of the ashes.
Thank you.
peace of our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.